Okay, so this is a type of pour that we're going to do real quick. This is a handy dandy cup, a plastic bag, and gallery wrapped canvas. Picked up a 4-pack of that for dirt cheap. Absolutely dirt cheap. It was awesome. And our Kershaw knife. So this is just a basic pour, but basically what I'm planning on doing is taking what's in the cup, transferring to bag. Bag goes on the canvas and the workaround. So let's get started.
Whites. I've been mixing up some blues and teals to give it a different feel. I love messing around with the different colors. You can change the texture of the blues, how fast they run. Just listening to chill out records.
Now, what happens is this actually changes up how the paint comes out because of the transfer to the bag. And it makes a really, really cool color variation.
Really, really cool.
Now, sometimes I'll add like just a small bit of color to the canvas beforehand or something like that, just to give it a little pop. It gives me something to work around, a target. These two whites, I've mixed them so they're different viscosities. Yellow. So now, you take the plastic bag, you do the transfer. Now, as it comes out, it mixes a little bit, but you turn it into pipet. Knife. It'll cut it. So, safety first. Look at the changes that you've made to each of the colors. You let gravity do its thing. Sometimes it takes a little bit longer. But when you finish it, should look something like this. So that's with a couple different blues, and some yellow, a little bit of pink. You can see it over here, and you can mix the colors together. The yellow and the blue, used correctly, will give you that green, but it'll still keep the yellow highlights in it. So that's kind of what I like doing. You know, everybody has their own techniques. I also used a little bit of orange in here to fully bring it out in the center. But when you're pouring it in, you have to be conscious that you're doing a double pour before you're doing the artwork itself. So you know that you're going to be mixing colors automatically. So you have to choose which colors are going to go together to give you the best contrast with the lowest amount of, you know, clashing. So I think overall this one really came out well. So hope you like it. Talk to y'all later.